Thank you, David. Good luck to you, son.
Thanks, Ruby. So I want to just tell you chaps a little bit about who I am, first of all. As Ruby said, I am an Nigerian, but I've never been to Nigeria. That's wow. Because I refuse to go to Nigeria until I can go to Nigeria with a racing car.
Wow. Awesome.
Nigeria, motor racing is all about. Motor racing isn't just a sport, but it's so much more. In England, it's a, I think, a £3 billion a year export industry. It's a massive part of the British economy. We can do the same in Nigeria. We can bring up racing drivers who will promote Nigeria and Africa around the whole world and change the perception of Africa that perhaps a lot of these Europeans have got wrong. And also, we can make quite a lot of money as building racing cars, designing racing cars. We can bring on the next generation of engineers, next generation of drivers. We can make something that the whole of Nigeria, the whole of Africa can be proud of. And that's what I hope me and Ovi initially can do. And we want to be bringing up, you know, a little country like St. Lucia or one of these Caribbean islands can produce someone like Lewis Hamilton. Why can't we produce 20 Lewis Hamiltons? You know, we should be owning Formula One. We should be owning World Touring Cars and World GT Championship. And I think motor racing is a great platform to promote the nation and what it really stands for. So, what have I driven before? Whole range of cars. I started off racing. I grew up in Crystal Palace here in South London. And I drove, as a boy, I saw the motor racing there and wanted to go and get involved. I didn't know how. I didn't have any money. I didn't have anything, but I decided that's what I wanted to do. And because I wanted to do it, I made it happen. And I think we need to show that example to all these Nigerian kids out there. In London, in America, and of course in Nigeria. And I hope for the River State as well as Lagos.
Yeah, what's your bus there?
We can show them that they too can become drivers, they can make their living, they can make a great career and advertise their nation around the world. So I started racing off the cheapest cars I could find, anything I could lay my hands on. It was an old Ford Fiesta which I built in a shed. And we went and raced that in Brands Hatch and all the famous racing circuits around England. Then I got a bit of sponsorship from a French company and that gave me enough money to go and race in France. And then from there, my career took me all over the world to America, around Europe and most of the UK. Now, my career as a driver is coming to its end. I'm getting old. I'm 30 years old now in racing terms. That's pretty solid. But my last project is hopefully going to be Racing Eagle. I want to make something, a legacy for drivers to bring through and bring racing to Africa in a way that's proper, not a way that Bernie Ecclestone's right in the South African Grand Prix where you've got a bunch of European and European looking guys with a bunch of other European looking guys. They're not Africans, right? We want proper Africa. There's an African Grand Prix, an African sports car race, an African circuit, an African championship. And we think that in the future, every one of you guys should be able to be racing as well. You can all be racing eagles. You don't, it doesn't just have to be us. So, you know, I think what I've driven and hopefully the experience I've gained doing that, I can take guys like Ovi and talk them through and hopefully I can work with guys like that and other young drivers, just advise them and help them get to where they want to be in racing, and guys would like really help them with circuits and tracks. So I'm sort of the guy who sits, hopefully, you know, I want to drive the car because it looks really fun, basically. I really want to drive this car and race this car. And yeah, I want to pick up some silverware along the way. I'm sure Ruby's going to get it, but it is. But
sorry.
My real aim is to have the team running, and then I can sit back on the pit wall and watch guys like Ovi go out and win championships, not do quite well in the race, not just go around on the track and be there. We're there to win, but it might take a few years, but we're going to get there. Right? I'd like to introduce you guys to Ovi. He's the first top driver.
Imagine how challenging it would be for me to be here actually, because growing up in Nigeria there's no sports, there's like everything's about football really. It's not football, it's athletics. No one's really into much sports in Nigeria. I've really been interested from a really young age. Then it's just now that the opportunities really come. When I started schooling in Scotland last year, I was speaking to some Formula Renault teams about how I can going to Formula Renault this year. And Formula Renault is actually it's a championship where Lewis Hamilton started from, so it's quite a good championship. It's like British Formula I need support and sponsorship to be able to race in that kind of championship. And then using the skills I learned from there to race for the racing AV team and just take our country's name further in all the youth sports. Because the past few months now, all the news we've been hearing about Nigeria has just been bad news and bad reports about riots, bombings and everything. But then we can bring some news back to Nigeria by applying some